Hi Taurus, welcome to your Y reading for August 5th through September 4th. Everything you need to know about this reading is in the description box below, as well as the recommend a reader shout out link, which goes to Little Light of Mind. Love that name. Much love and support to her, and hopefully you get a chance to check her out and show her some love and support as well, if you like what she has to say. Lastly, this is intended for a romantic love read, but it could resonate in other areas of your life, such as family, friendship, work, or job, even money. All right, Taurus, what is your why? Think of your why. Hopefully this offers some clarification, confirmation, or answers a question. All right, Taurus. We've got the Emperor here. Devil, Hangman, Four of Pentacles. Can you see, is that really? It's gonna be like that. Is it? Are we doing that? Okay. Three of Swords, Page of Cups, Hermit, and the Three of Wands. All right. So. Just get a look here. All right, so we've got, let's see. Is this a question of someone's thinking about, all right, is this worth it or not? In particular, your why, or I'm sorry, your person, Taurus. It looks like they're thinking about, is this worth it? They're kind of wondering if there's, if you two are on the same page, and they might be taking some time to be thinking about that. Because right now it looks like this is something that has gone either stale, or they're thinking that it's just not a, excuse me, it's not a, they're being held back, you're being held back, this is not a healthy relationship. There could be some unbalanced control issues here where someone's really controlling. We've got the Emperor and the Four of Pentacles. Okay, so enough spitballing. All right, so we've got other cards. Let me get to those that came out as well. All right, so we have this Three of Cups and the Five of Swords here. And it could be that because of someone's indulging, things were cut off, or things, someone felt like they had to make some necessary decisions and cuts to their life. You know, had to cut away the things that were no longer serving them. And they're in a period of reflection, deciding if this is worth it or not to continue. And this also is someone that is like, you know what, maybe this was a codependent relationship. Maybe this wasn't healthy. This wasn't, there was an imbalance of power here, a lot of control. And someone's trying to do their own thing. They're trying to start off on their own. We've got the Seven of Wands. We've got the Page of Wands. We've got Seven of Pentacles and the Five of Pentacles. And again, right here, you can't really see it, but we have the reflection, taking the time out for reflection right here. So for thinking. And we've got three fours, which is also taking some time to think and reflection and all that. So this is... It's not over though. That's the thing. It doesn't feel over. It feels like someone will be coming back. It feels like you'll be going back. This isn't over between you two. Okay. What's this devil about? What is it? It'll come. All right. What's this devil about? Ten of Pentacles. So this could be that it was basically, not basically, never is basic, but security is tying you two together. The need for stability and security, in the sense that maybe someone is staying because they can't afford to move. Maybe someone likes the lifestyle, so they're staying, or maybe someone is out of work, so they need, you know, there's out of work here. Maybe someone's out of work, so they need the stability that a double income or someone working can bring, that sort of thing. So whatever it is, though, it's tied to security and it's become unhealthy and stagnant. And it's kind of, someone might feel trapped or held hostage, especially with an imbalance of power. Let's see. What's this hangman about? Oh. So is it you that left? Is it you that ended things? What's this? Hold on a minute. What's this Four of Pentacles? Three of Pentacles here, or Three of Cups here, or Three of Cups here. So is this someone that had an affair? Is this an affair and things were cut off because of that? Someone just callously and carelessly had an affair, cheating, indulging, and yet someone feels like they can't leave because of the financial situation or because of the stability and security they need right now. If nothing else, a roof over their head and the kids' heads, right? But, So it looks like this person, was it on both sides? Was it cheating? Did both of you do things against each other? Was there betrayal on both sides? Because it feels like, and I guess that's what the unhealthy or the codependent part of it is, because it feels like this person left because of the indulging or the no boundaries. Someone just kind of was really fluid and prioritized either image or partying or social life or some kind of like minor vice, like cheating or partying a bit too much, but that slowly started to become like a thing. And it was almost like that thing was more important than the connection, because, you know, after a while, we take the stability and someone being around for granted, right? So did they leave because of the control issues and because someone was really, or, well, let's be honest, they're laying this at your feet, Taurus. So this is someone that feels like, you know, this was inevitable, this ending. It was out of their hands. There was nothing they could do about this because of the way the dynamic is between you two. And they felt like things were just too controlling. We got the Four of Pentacles and the Emperor here, and that it was either more of a priority for you to do what you wanted to do and have a good time and have fun and whatnot, but there was no commitment or connection to the relationship any longer. What's this Three of Swords about? This Three of Swords. See, it's not done. Okay, we got the Knight of Swords here. What's this Hermit about? Judgment. So did you leave? What the heck? Is it on both sides? Like both of you have done stuff? Because we've got this person feeling like there's nothing they can do about this, but still wanting to be a part of it. And round and round you both go. It feels like you've both done things to, it's gotten hairy. It's gotten messy, but this person still wants to come back and be a part of this, knowing full well the dynamic, knowing that something is not right. So they're taking time out to think, but then they're not done with it yet. And it's almost like this redemption cycle where they really mess up, but you messed up too. So they're going to be the first one to extend the olive branch. But right now you two are like in a period of separation. We got a sudden ending here, the Knight of Swords. This is someone that's trying to get out in front of something. Did you go to them and ask for reconciliation first? Oh. This is them feeling like they were expendable to you. This is them feeling like if you were to come around and make the sacrifice, put them first, prioritize a relationship instead of control, you prioritize connection, that they would still be willing to give this a chance. But the way things stand now, and again, Taurus, they're laying this at your feet, they feel like they can't win, that they just, that you won't look at your culpability in a situation, that you won't look at, when you're wrong, that you're not able to apologize, that you're not willing to look at both sides of the argument or put yourself in your person's shoes, and that there's an inordinate amount of control, and you strike first and maybe discuss later. But there's a sense that they feel like you don't value them, and that you haven't, and that you're more about others focused. You're more about the stuff that you want to do, and kind of like life is a party, or just, you know, having what you want and it being about you and what you want rather than the other person. And they feel like they're not put first, that it's more about control, and they just, there's nothing that they can do about this, that you have all the control in the relationship, or that you had it, and it's, and there's some cruelty here too. We got Five of Swords, Knight of Swords, Three of Swords, Ten of Swords. These are cutting words, that type of thing. So this could be some cruel things were said, or when it comes down to problem solving, that there's like more of like a verbal abuse than there is getting to the bottom of the issue. Someone's trying to be right rather than trying to understand. It's like, you know, it's that whole thing that when someone asks why, is it because you want to understand where I'm coming from, or is it because you want to dismantle my argument and shoot holes through it and keep me in the defensive position while you maintain control of the interrogation? Like, you know what I mean? Like, it slowly morphs into, so, and it's not, this is just them. This is about how they feel and how they see things. So this is not saying true or not, but for the Tauruses that I'm reading for, this is someone that feels really undervalued in the relationship and feels like they don't really have a chance. They just feel really controlled. They feel like they can't leave, possibly because of security issues or, you know, stability issues. They need the money. There's something that keeps them there. But this is someone who's really suffering over the relationship because they feel like they're not respected or valued, and they feel like you, Taurus, are unkind with your words and your choices, and you don't have any regard for them, and it's all about what you want and that sort of thing. So what's this Page of Cups? Page of Wands. And this is someone that is probably still going to reach out when all is said and done. What's this Three of Wands about? So that kind of fell out. What's this Three of Wands about? Okay, whoever is the person, no, it's not some, you two are talking about it. No, no one's offered. This is someone, though, that is going to see about still being civil or kind of still maintaining some sort of connection. Possibly because there's something they need, or you two are still connected somehow. And this person, because of that connection, this person is attempting to be civil. But I also think it's almost like someone, okay, you know what it's like? It's like two people that are no longer going to be married or live together or whatnot, but they still have to live together, but they're only in name only living together. They're not connected romantically anymore. And someone is now going to start dating, even while they're living with their ex-person or whatnot. They need to stay there for financial reasons. Stability reason, they got kids, whatever the reason is, they can't move out or they can't leave. They're still going to be under the same roof, but this is about someone else still or starting to date or starting to pursue other interests other than the family or the person. So instead of being at your own separate places, moving out, moving on, it feels like you're both still under the same roof or still connected, very tied and connected somehow, and yet someone else is still choosing to date even while in, I guess, that connection somehow. So are there kids involved? What is it? I don't know what it is, but you two are still connected, and maybe that's this hangman piece where they feel like they can't move on or they're stuck. I thought it was about, you know, the way things are. They can't change it, and that's why they feel so betrayed, is because they literally don't have a chance. They're not valued. Someone's not willing to sacrifice and see the other side of things. That they're putting it at your feet, Taurus. But this also could be that this is... That they're literally stuck in the house. Whatever there is, this is okay. So this is a call for calm. Your call to action here, honestly, is about being taking a beat, taking a minute, thinking about some things. We have a lot of fours here, and that means give things pause. We got a four here, where's the other four? Four here. There needs to be time to consider your options, whatever you are doing, Taurus, because this is the hot-headed night right here. Whatever you are doing or whatever you have been doing, this is saying to slow down and to think about things and consider your choices before you do anything. Wait for someone's answer. Wait for someone's communication on something. Wait and take some time to see what you want to do. But I was going to say how you feel, but I think this is, we got 2 7 of pentacles here. This is, something was going down, or that you were in the process. There's this flurry happening and this probably sudden ending. And this is saying, cool your jets, hold on, think about things. And that looks like too, one of the reasons why you two didn't work out or were having problems is because there isn't that time to reflect. There isn't that time to consider all facets of a story or an interaction and how someone else feels, or you know what I mean? Like there's a real kind of stubbornness and yet hot-headedness or whatever. This is how this person is seeing it. So whatever you're in the middle of doing or thinking or whatever, this is about thinking, considering your options and thinking about, okay, is it going to be worth it? Is it going to bring you the results that you want? Whatever you're in the midst of doing, is it going to bring you the results you want? And furthermore, is it a decision you made by yourself or with your person? Is it more the same of you just going out there and doing what you want, or is it with your person in mind? And it's very strange because it feels like there's an ending, but you two are still very connected, and this person is even still willing to work things out if things were to change, if they could see that you were trying to make a change or whatnot. But right now they just kind of feel like, you know, I don't have a chance. There's no room for me in this relationship. And yet they feel stuck and controlled the way things are now. And yet they'd still be willing to talk and if they saw that things were starting to change. All right, what else for Taurus? Self. So it's not funny. It's interesting because sitting here talking about how, you know, it was one-sided, your person didn't feel valued. They felt like it was all about you and, you know, selfish and that sort of thing. And we have self here. So this is, but I also think that it's about considering what you want instead of being rushing foolhardy off into things or just getting out in front of something and being controlling and having those heated arguments and erupting and escalating just so you can position yourself to get what you want, right? If that's true, how your person sees you. This is about being able to stop and reflect and connect with yourself to see what you really want before you react. This is about just cooling your jets. Whatever the intensity is, see if that can be calmed a little bit. Because that's not, it's keeping you alienated from other. It's keeping you from going from one thing to the next, to the next, to the next. This could be minor addiction or minor, the need to constantly, there's something here about needing to be a part of the next party or the next thing or the next, like something about the partying or some kind of indulgence that could give a rush here with the Knight of Swords and the Three of Cups. That's about needing to always have that kind of intensity, that rush from some kind of indulgence, partying, porn, gambling, affairs, that sort of thing. And always on to the next one. And it's something you do by yourself and it ends as quick as it starts and then on to the next, and because it provides a certain level of something that you feel you need to maintain. So again, this is how your person is seeing it. It's not, you know, if it doesn't resonate, it doesn't resonate. What would Taurus's person say to them? I'm finally feeling the consequences of my actions. Okay, so is this, see, there's a, that thing again where it's like, did both of you do this? Did both of you have affairs? Did both of you betray each other? Did both of you, or both of you stuck and you're miserable, but neither one can afford to buy the other person out? So you both have kind of messed around on each other or done things that would betray or hurt or whatever. But I mean, it's weird because on the one hand, it feels really one-sided, like this person doesn't feel valued at all, and they feel like you just have all the control, and you're neglectful, and you're unkind, and you're cruel with your words and all that. But then were they too? Because look at this, I'm finally feeling the consequences of my actions, and we've got indulgence on both sides here. Okay, all right. I'm just throwing that out there. What else for Taurus? Three of Swords. Ouch. It's two of those. Part of this, too, though, is about you've been here before. It's kind of an expected cycle that you two are going through. And honestly, it feels like it involves trust. Because as long as the cycle continues, until you two finally talk and hear each other, it's just going to be, you're just going to keep hurting each other and not leaving. And because you're not going to truly listen to, now, if this person is not worth listening to, I mean, this is all kinds of connected and kind of nuanced and interwoven, but ideally, here she comes. Sorry. Ideally, if there's trust issues, someone will be able to leave. But for whatever reason, you two keep doing this dance. This is about knowing the same thing's going to happen again. But, and I don't want to sound hokey or winsome or, you know, the whimsical, whatever it is. But honestly, it happens again because you keep doing the same things. And instead of listening to each other, everybody reacts and assumes. And it's like, you know, look, I'm going to probably cheat. I'm screwed up. I've got this and this going on. And that's the way it's going to be. I mean, not that that would happen, but it starts there. It starts with that conversation. It starts with being honest and listening to each other. Not like, oh, I know what you're going to say and you're going to do that. Well, looks like you got it all figured out then. I'll just be on my way. But this is about not being able to trust each other. Because you both keep doing the same thing that brings you back to the same position and nothing gets resolved except for more heart. I mean, nothing gets resolved and it's just more heartache and round and round we go. And this has got you both. And I'm sorry. And I don't mean, I'm not, I hope I don't sound insensitive, but I feel bad because this just needs to get, you two are like this. I mean, it feels like I don't know where one of you starts and the other one ends and you need to whoosh, and both of you need to own your stuff. Okay, what else here? I'm sorry. I mean, I could see why there's the Four of Swords here and why it's, we got a bunch of fours showing up, because this is, you both need to have time to think and to not react anymore. Just think. Both of you need to get to like a safe place to where you can just think about what you want to do. And if you want to work this out or not, then devise a plan. However, you know what I mean? And I don't need to tell you that, I know, but it just, it's just, what else for Taurus? Because there's hurt on both sides. And you can't, unless you grieve and listen and talk to each other, you're not going to move past this because you're both hurt and yet you're both still doing the same thing to each other. That's for Taurus. That makes me sad, honestly, because it makes me want to like, okay, everybody, let's just, because there was a love there once, you know? And then now it's devolved to this and it just, oh, God. We got bickering and arguing and fighting and cursing and, you know, I mean, just, That was for Taurus. Ah, damn it. There's that devil again. Mother trucker. We got the devil and we got the magician. Damn it. That's heavy. That is heavy duty. This is, you two cannot keep doing this to each other. This is about, you need to figure this out. And this is also doubling down on the control and the kind of just, this is like a situation where you can't leave it. There's some kind of control here. There's some kind of, somebody's got something over somebody, or somebody's got a hold on somebody. Somebody feels like somebody has a hold on somebody, but there's that feeling like I can't break away from this situation. And yet it feels like it's tearing you two apart. And we've got heavy duty control and feeling stuck and like you can't leave. And that particularly someone, the way your person sees it, Taurus, it feels like you both have this effect on each other, but the way your person sees it, they're laying this at your feet. So, you know, and I said earlier that the way they see it is that you have this, you don't have the ability to see both sides of the argument, that you're kind of one-sided, you're very selfish, that sort of thing. The same, honestly, could be said about them, because it takes two and you both are just at each other. All right. I wish you luck. I'm sorry. I wish you luck with this. I wish it was happier. I hope you two are able to hear each other authentically, or it's about starting to talk to someone else that can maybe help you sort this out if you're both amenable. Your person looks like they are. I hope you two are able to find your way to each other again. Start to talk and communicate. This is very heavy. I hope to see you in the next reading. I hope this was helpful and I wish you luck with this. Okay, Taurus? All right. Hope to see you in the next reading. You take care.